So having looked at the role of the public-private partnership in the previous model, in this model we want to also look at the role of international supports, or what I call the advocacy coalition, in curbing the housing issues in African cities. So according to Stephen Giddings back in 2007, these four priorities: affordable land for housing, housing finance, slum upgrading, and urban infrastructure represent both critical needs of African cities to deal effectively with urban exclusion, as well as areas where the US is technically well equipped to offer technical and financial assistance. So far in this chapter, I'll be analyzing the current challenges posed by rapid urbanization in Africa. We also identified housing as a catalytic tool for economic growth, and have also outlined the existing constraints and industry challenges, and we equally have discussed the untapped potentials from the organization challenges, part of which is a holistic approach by the government through public-private partnerships. So a prerequisite for these opportunities to be realized still remains sound government policies that enable the private sector as well as involve the urban dwellers. It is only when they are enabling policies with results to show that international body support can be assured. According to Stephen Giddings once again back in 2007, African housing advocates in both the government and the private sector need to redouble efforts to increase the priority of housing and urban development in national policy and planning exercises and in national investment programs. They must play a more forceful role in influencing national policy than they have done heretofore, and must educate African government leaders on the impact that housing investment can have on the country's development. However, achieving the much needed results will require international and national support. By assisting the local African organizations to form more powerful coalitions, US-based NGOs and housing advocacy organizations can help to strengthen the messages and the influence on the international policy makers. So from this model, we've seen that it also requires some international support to solve the African housing issues, as well as the public-private partnership. All this will come together to help to address Africa's housing menace. In the next module and the last module for this chapter, we'll be looking at the role technology has to play in solving this problem as well. I'll see you there.